discuss the topic reproduction. So what is a reproduction? This is a vital process in all living organisms. The parents are producing new individuals generation after generation. When these individuals are sexually mature, then able to reproduce a young ones. Why reproduction is essential? Reproduction is essential to maintain the size of their species. Without reproduction, organism or species cannot survive for the long period of time. So that is the aim of reproduction. Reproduction is two types. One method, that is asexual, and another one, that is sexual. In asexual and sexual mode of reproduction, one is asexual. Asexual means there is no involvement of gamete. What is gamete? Gamete are reproductive cells or sex cells which are produced inside the gonads. Where this is produced? Gonads. What is gonad? Gonads are primary reproductive organ. What is this? Primary reproductive organ. In the case of male, gonads is called testes, and in the case of female, that is ovary. So inside the gonads, gametes are produced. Male produce sperm and female produce ovum. So in asexual reproduction, there is no involvement of gamete. Very important. And in the sexual reproduction, there is involvement of gametes and fertilization is take place. So what is fertilization? What is fertilization? Fertilization is a process of fusion of male and female gamete. When male gamete sperm are fused with ovum and form a zygote, that process is called fertilization. This zygote are developed into a new one, the new individual. So that is a fertilization and involvement of gamete in the sexual reproduction. Another difference between asexual and sexual mode of reproduction, because in the asexual reproduction there is no involvement of gamete, so variation cannot take place. What is mean of variation? Variation means variety and difference of individual. That is same type of individual are produced, that is called clone. What is called clone? Clone is genetically and morphologically similar to their parents. Like in gametes, there is a 23 chromosome, 23 in sperm and 23 in ovum. So due to the fusion, zygote is formed. This zygote is less and more identical to the parents. That shows the variation, and this variation transferred to the next generation and formation of new species. But in the sexual reproduction, clone are not produced. There is a variation take place and new species can form. That is a difference. If you are saying that which method is more efficient or more chance of survival, So your answer is sexual mode of reproduction. Those organisms having sexual mode of reproduction, they having more chance of adaptation due to the variation. They having high chance to adapt according to the condition. So they having more chance of survival than asexual mode of reproduction. Very important. So that is two methods, asexual and sexual. Next, we move types of asexual reproduction, methods of. First, that is budding. Very important. What is budding? Bud is an outgrowth of parent body that are able to develop into a new individual, yeah, young ones. That is called budding. So, budding is present in Hydra or yeast. So that is a bud part which are detached from the parent, are attached, are able to develop into a young new individual. They are new hydra. That process is called budding. Example, yeast and hydra. Next one, binary fission. What is mean of binary fission? In this method of asexual reproduction, parent body are divided, parent cell are divided into two daughter cells. How many cells? That is, parent cells divide into two daughter cells which are identical to the parent, identical to the parent body. That process is called binary fission. So in the binary fission, mitotic division is take place. First, this nucleus is divide and then cell divide. So that process is called binary fission. This process mainly present in the unicellular organism like bacteria, amoeba, paramecium, euglena. That is an example of binary fission. Very important. Next one, there is multiple fission. In multiple fission, like in binary fission, two daughter cells, but in the multiple fission, parent cells are divided into the two daughter cells and these cells are divided into the many cells. Multiple division is take place, that is called multiple fission. So this process takes place in unfavorable condition. In which condition? Unfavorable condition, and form many tiny spores. Like in the case of amoeba, that is a hard covering over the skinny spores, that is called cyst. That cyst during the favorable condition burst, break out and release large number of tiny amoeba. That is called sporulation. What is called? Sporulation. So that is take place in amoeba also and in parasites like in plasmodium. So that is three one, budding, binary fission and multiple fission. Another example is, another method of asexual reproduction, regeneration. What do you mean of regeneration? The last part of the body, a detached part of the body, are able to develop into a new individual. That is called regeneration. So regeneration mainly present in the planarians, also in hydra. So they have show the ability to develop into a new individual. That process is called regeneration. So that is a method of asexual reproduction. In the case of plant, this asexual reproduction is called vegetative propagation or vegetative reproduction. Vegetative part of the plant like leaf, root, stem are able to develop into a new plant. That is called vegetative propagation, a vegetative reproduction. So there is example like stem, underground stem. So we eaten a stem part like in a potato. That is a stem part. So there is a potato, there is a swollen part that is called tuber. Tuber, this part having stored food material in the form of starch. This tuber containing small eye buds. What is containing? Small buds. When you cut this potato into many pieces, these buds are developed into a new potato plant. That is an example of underground stem. Very important. Another example of stem is, that is rhizome, present in ginger. This is also an example of underground stem, present in ginger. Another example, like bulb in onion, bulbil in agave. Many example of underground stem. Another example of vegetative propagation, that is root. root is a lower parts of the plant which what is function of root absorption of the water main function another function is exchange of the gases storage of food material that other parts of root so in radish carrot and sweet potato that is containing adventitious root that is also example of root so this root are able to develop into a new plant so that is very important another one that is leaf bud in bryophyllum bryophyllum is a plant so in this plant there is a in a corner where leaf buds are present these leaf buds when detached from the plant when get nourishment are able to develop into a new plant formation of root and shoot the leaf buds example of bryophyllum so that is a vegetative propagation so artificially vegetative propagation is used advantage is that large number of similar type of plant are produced in less time this is also used in gardeners like in the case of stem cutting done in the rose so cut the stem part of the rose and embedded into the soil that new plants of rose are developed so cutting layering and grafting that is a artificial method of vegetative propagation so advantage large number of similar type plant are produced disease resistant or disease free plant can be produced good quality of plant are produced in they required less attention than the seed plants developed those plant which have lost the ability to developed seed so also seedless plant also produced by this method that's the advantage of vegetative propagation very important so that is a sexual reproduction and fertilization